Okay, so the last of the trifecta of vectors. We are going to have two non-perpendicular vectors. So this complicates things just a bit. We still are using our geometry skills, particularly with angles and parallelograms and how consecutive angles are supplementary at 180 degrees. And that's been key in solving these problems. We're going to bring in probably one more issue here, and that is how close your resultant vector is to one of the two directions that we have to compare to, as in west of north, or west of south, or say north of east, whatever. We have to establish that main direction of whatever. So put all this together. I will take this scenario, take our bird again that's going at 12 and a half meters per second, only this time it's going 30 degrees north of east. And now we still have that 5 meter per second wind that only this time is going to be going 20 degrees north of west. And we want to know what resulting velocity our bird is going to end up in. And so what we're going to do here is look at the parallelogram that's resulted. Now, this is the 5, 20 degrees north of west that is being described here for our wind, and our bird is traveling 12.5 meters per second, 30 degrees north of east. So we make our parallelogram opposite parallel, which doesn't look all that parallel with my drawing abilities, thank you very much, but kind of is. And our resultant of this parallelogram is going to go from the beginning point to the opposite side of the parallelogram, and we're going to solve for x. Now, I've already done the problem because I screwed up the first video and I had all this put up already, so if you need me to do this again in class, please feel free to ask me. I'll be more than happy to do it. But resultant here is dependent upon this triangle right here. This angle here is 20 and this angle here is 30, so that means this angle of the parallelogram is 180 minus 50, which is 130 degrees. So that angle right there is 130 degrees, which I have written right there. That means this angle here that's opposite our unknown side within the triangle, because we know it's 12 and a half here and 5 here, is going to have an angle value of 50. Now the question is, why did I pick this triangle as opposed to this triangle? And the main reason is that I try to use triangles that are completely in one of the four quadrants, or in this case, one of the two quadrants, because we don't have any more negative here. And this is the one that fits that bill. This one, you see the triangle is found in both quadrants. It tends to get a bit messy. You can still solve it, still can be done, but I like to keep things as simplified as possible. And, you know, simplified in physics sometimes are oxymorons, but let's pretend like they're not. So, we use the law of cosines to figure this out. So we come over here, C equals the square root of, now again, doesn't make any difference what you say is A or B. So I generally make the smaller one A and the larger one B, and it doesn't make any difference, but I use 5 squared plus 12.5 squared minus the correction factor for the Pythagorean theorem, 2AB cosine C. So 2 times 5 times 12.5 times the cosine of this angle right here, which is 50 degrees. That is opposite that C in that triangle. We get a value 10.0 meters per second. Okay, I plug that in right here, and now I can find out this angle right here by using the law of sines. Now, this angle right here that we don't know, well, we do, but before we pretend like we don't know, is opposite the 5. So the sine of angle x over 5 is the first relationship. And then we go with the pair that we do know. We just solved this 50 degrees for this 10.0 meters per second. So that's the second pair of angle slash side that we're going to use here. Cross multiply and divide this law of sines. And we get 10 sine x equals 5 sine 50. And then we divide by 10, get the sine of x by itself, and then we take the inverse sine and change that from sine of x to x. So x is going to equal this, which is going to be equal to 22.5 degrees. But it's 22.5 degrees in this particular triangle. It's not 22.5 degrees away from the eastern direction. We already have 30 degrees away from the eastern direction, plus an additional 22.5 degrees. So that makes this 52.5 degrees north of east when I add those two together. The problem with that is that it's telling us that it's actually closer to the north direction than it is the east direction. So we have to flip-flop the order of the north and east to become east and north, which we can do by realizing that this is a 90 degree angle right here. So we want to show the relationship from north as opposed to east. We subtract 90 from that 52.5 from the 90, and we get 37.5 degrees east of north. And so that is going to be the resultant factor right there, the resultant angle. Okay, so actually I'll call that x sub 2 because it's the second x, this is the first x. Okay, so it's going to take a little bit of practice to get used to this, but it's not really that much different from the previous discussion that we had when we had one direction and one non-perpendicular. That was like training wheels, that one was. This is going to be the real riding of the bicycle on the gravelly road. See how your balance goes. So, your practice problems are right here. I have the script. If you want to follow along the script too as I went through this, I was explicit on that as well. And again, if this was just too rushed and you don't really understand what I did, talk to me in class and we'll do it again in class, okay? All right, good luck.